What are we eating tonight?
Today we're making breakfast pizza.
Coach Adam and PK here, making breakfast pizza in the queue. We're at the stage of quarantine where Drop the Puck Productions is getting stir crazy, and we decided that we wanted to share some good cheer with the Wildcats Nation. So today we're making breakfast pizza, as PK says. This is a recipe that came from Disney World when I was a kid. Went there on a family vacation, and this is one of the things that we tried for the first time, and we loved it. So we started making it throughout the years. It became a tradition here at the Leeds house. So here we go. So the first step in breakfast pizza is to put a little bit over a tablespoon of butter in a saucepan, small saucepan. The idea is we're making a roux. In the industry, we call it a roux.
What's a roux?
What's a roux? Well, Anthony knows. A roux is a mixture of butter and flour and milk. And that's milk. So, we get the butter, pull it down a little bit. We don't want it too hot. And then we're gonna stir in tablespoon, a little over a tablespoon of flour. And stir that up. And keep stirring that. You don't want it to burn. I always say a little over a tablespoon because originally this recipe is good for a 7-inch pizza, but as you'll be seeing during this, we're making a like a full-size pizza, basically, so it's a little bigger. So we had to just add all the ingredients a little bit more. So now that the butter and flour are basically together, thickening up, now we're gonna pour it in slowly a little bit over a quarter cup of milk. We're gonna stir this in until it thickens up. This could take a little bit of time. It's actually thickening up a lot faster than usual. It usually takes a couple minutes, but this is actually already working. So we're gonna let this. So we're gonna keep stirring.
Is that recording?
Yes, it is. So we're gonna keep stirring that up. So while PK here is stirring the roux, what I'm going to do is I'm going to preheat the oven to 400.
400.
400.
What do we do with the roux after we're done stirring it?
Well, PK, I'm glad you asked. What we need to do with the roux after we're done stirring it is we need to put it into a mixing bowl and put it into the refrigerator to cool it down while we prepare the next portion of this meal. Mm.
Thank you.
You're welcome. As a side note, Jess Watchner is working the cameras. She might make an appearance, she might not.
All depends.
All depends. But it's strictly dubs.
Always.
Always. So how are we doing with this room?
Looks pretty good.
Let's give the
viewers a look.
Yeah, there it is. You know any jokes, PK?
No.
Yeah. Oh, there goes that.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Boo.
Boo-hoo?
Don't cry, it's a joke.
Oh, jeez. There might be some editing in TV land. No cuts.
No cuts.
All right, looks like we're doing pretty good. This is turning into a little bit of a... Go. So now we're going to take this and we're going to put it into our mixing bowl. Nice?
Yep.
Nicey nice.
Very good.
So now, that's going to go in the refrigerator. Okay, so now that the roux is in the refrigerator cooling off, the next step in breakfast pizza is eggs. So what we're going to do is we're going to butter a saucepan, medium size, because this is a lot of eggs. And this is going to, you have to be buttering. For a 7-inch pizza, all you need, not all of it, just half of it. For a 7-inch pizza, you're going to need a 3 eggs. We're making something about twice the size of that, so a little bit more than twice the size. So we're actually using 7 eggs for this. And we're going to mix this up. Now you want to lightly scramble your eggs. It doesn't have to be cooked all the way through because it's going to be in that 400 degree oven.
It's hot.
That's hot.
Very hot.
Alright, looks like we're ready for some eggs. So PK and I would much rather be at the hockey rink with everybody, but we're making the most of quarantine, and we hope everyone is healthy and safe at their houses. Mm-hmm. And we hope this brings some smiles on to everyone. Mm-hmm. Drop the Puck Productions crew is also being quarantined. They're making other wonderful, wonderful dishes that if you're so inclined, you can go on YouTube and watch. Okay, at this stage, what we are going to do is we are going to fold the eggs into the roux. So we have to take the roux out of the refrigerator.
Here's the roux.
The slightly chilled roux.
Still hot though.
Well, it's okay. So here we go. Now, PK is going to fold that into right there. How are we doing, PK?
We're doing very good. The roux is being folded into the eggs.
Nice assist. Hockey joke. And now what we're going to do is we're going to add our spices. So, you can spice to taste. What we put in this bowl right here is, what do we put in there? We put pepper, a little bit of red pepper. We put garlic. We put salt. Oregano and a little bit of basil. And don't put the whole thing in. Remember, you gotta, you know, we learned from another one of the videos that you never pour directly into the bowl.
You gotta put your hand and measure promptly.
Because that's probably good. It looks like we don't need the rest of it. Okay, so there you go. This is the filler for our breakfast pizza. Okay, so now we are going to put all the ingredients together. We have our egg roux mixture, we have a pizza crust, and we have cheese. Pizza crust, we usually use Boboli's for this. In this case, we got a pizza crust or pizza dough from a local pizzeria. But if you actually know how to cook, like, don't, but if you know how to cook, you can make your own pizza dough. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna put the eggs and all our nice spices right there in the center of the pizza. Right in the center.
Right in the center.
All right.
That's a trick.
That was a nice trick. And we're gonna flatten out. Wanting to leave your crust at the edge because you want your nice pizza crust. Okay, looks good. So, what other ingredients are on pizza?
Cheese.
Cheese. Right. So, now we are going to cheese the pie.
I've washed my hands.
Everybody wash their hands, yes. 17,000 times because we're in quarantine. Mm-hmm. And that's just what you gotta do. All right, so here you go. Cheese. This cheese, you can do any kind of cheese you like. This is a mixture of cheddar, Parmesan, and some mystery cheese.
Yesterday's milk.
Yesterday's milk. You can put as much cheese or as little cheese as you want.
Or no cheese.
But you'd be good. Look at this.
Put a lot of cheese.
We put a lot of cheese on there. All right, so there you go. So that is our cheese egg pizza. Now it's done. You can just pop this thing in the oven and wait 20 minutes for it to cook. Or you can add toppings, right?
What kind of toppings do you like?
I like bacon.
I like bacon too. As a matter of fact, we have bacon.
Oh.
So we're going to rip these things up, I guess?
Yeah.
Let's throw them on here. Again, our hands are washed. And even if they weren't, two guys aren't gonna be eating this anyways.
Feel bad for you guys.
You can use sausage, you can use pepperoni, you can put chicken on there, you can leave it plain.
Anything you want.
Anything you want. And that's it. So let's put this in the oven, and in 20 minutes we'll see how it comes out.
Now we are putting the pizza in the oven.
Pizza in the oven, 400 degrees, top shelf.
It's pretty hot.
Pretty hot, top shelf for 20 minutes. Okay, and now it is time to take out the pizza. It has been 20 minutes. Okay, what do you think, PK?
Looks very good.
Looks good. So, this was 20 minutes in the oven. We have to let it cool now for a little bit, and then we will cut it just like a pizza and serve.
The pizza has cooled.
The pizza has cooled. How does this look, Pika?
Looks very good.
Looks good. Looks really good. All right, so now we're going to cut it up into pizza slices and enjoy. Look at that, huh?
It's very good.
Look at that.
Oh, God.
Yeah, we almost dropped the pizza.
That would not have been fun.
Yes. And there you go. So we're gonna dig into this, and might as well try it, right?
Yeah. Very good slice of pizza. Very hot.
Very hot. How was it? Good?
That was good.
So again, from our house to yours, we hope you guys are all safe and healthy during this time, and PK just dropped some pizza on his foot. But seriously, we hope you all are healthy and happy, safe, and we'll see you at the rink soon. Thanks.